Thank you very much, everyone, for coming today, and also for the last 3 days. I think over the 3 days, I've met many of my father's old friends. I've also met many members of the public, and I thank you on behalf of my family for sharing your memories and your thoughts about my father. On Tuesday, when my mother and myself went to arrange for flowers for the casket, we were told that we should have bright flowers. So you have pink flowers on the casket. And the reason was because for anyone over 80 years old, it signifies full life. So it shouldn't be dark colors, it should be bright colors. So I hope we take today's opportunity to celebrate, not to mourn. And we are also pleased to have two close friends of the family who wishes to share a few words about their memories of my father. And I hope you would also give them your time and presence. Okay. So may I call upon Professor Arthur Lim firstly to come up and share.
Teachers, family, dear friends and colleagues, I noticed many of you, including the person who wrote this, met Lim Hock Siew this year. Let me tell you, a few of us here have known Hock Siew in 1950, 62 years ago. And they are here, some have come from Malaysia and so on. And can I have them as girl? Go Hong Ling. And of course, you know Poh Soo Kai. Brother, Poh Soo Chan. We were friends for over 60 years. What should I say about my dear friend? I think one thing which is very important about Hock Siew is that he is a very good doctor, a very good practitioner. Let me explain. In fact, to make it easy, I looked up the newspaper, and there were two articles written on Lim Hock Siew. Let me find the day. Lim Hock Siew came across as a very caring family doctor. The long queue of patients to see him every day illustrate that he has been kind to his patient. He said, when he saw Dr. Lim, and in a period he lost his job, Dr. Lim won't collect any money. He said, when you get your job back, then you can pay me. And this person concluded that Lim Hock Siew is the people's doctor, very important for Singapore. This is because many young doctors, many general practitioners and specialists today overcharge patients and do not care that much for patients. So Hock Siew's great contribution is that he cared very much for his patients. Someone also wrote in one of the reports that he should document and report about the contributions of Lim Hock Siew. I think they will do that. I see Mr. Xia that he is a publisher. Maybe he should sit down and publish something about Lim Hock Siew, not only about his other activities, but as a great doctor, as an example for other doctors in Singapore, an example for other doctors around the world. His political activities is well known, written here all around, and I think I should leave that part and come to a very important contribution. One of the greatest, 20 years in jail without trial. There are very few people who have done that. And each time they offered, you sign something, you can get out. And there was a long article. You know this Mandela from South Africa. He was asked many times, you sign this, you can go out. Hock Siew refused to sign. So he remained 20 years and left in 1982. The lesson here is that he has made contribution by sacrificing himself 20 years, not only important for the country to know that we had a government which are not very democratic. And I think we hope that Hock Siew's passing away would tell us that the government of today got to change. Otherwise, we will not be a democratic country. To end, he was supported by an intelligent and wonderful lady. And of course, we know who? Beatrice, his wife, Beatrice. Thank you very much.
I invite Mr. Chen Guofang to come up and say a few words.
Tunjing the Uso Yisang.各位家属成员，各位朋友，今天大家聚集在这里，准备给我们敬爱的林福寿医生送上最后一程。想大家的心里跟我一样，必然非常沉重，同时也会依依不舍。在这里，让我们简短地回顾一下。 林福寿医生不平凡的一生。那么接下来，我想以 Dr. Lim 来称呼他，因为这不单是他生前许多病人给他的称呼，而且也是他的众多的同志和战友们，尤其是那些跟他在樟宜牢房里，包括我自己。 一同过着黑暗的日子的朋友们，给他的尊称。Dr. Lim 于1931年出生在一个贫苦的大家庭，家中共有10名孩子，他排行第三。从小他便是个品学兼优的学生，就读莱福士书院的时候，他的领导才华。 便已经崭露头角，受到老师和同学们的肯定和欣赏。在学校里，他是公认的演说家和作家，经常代表学校参加校际演讲比赛和辩论会。1950年，他进入当时设在新加坡的马来亚大学攻读医科。 1953年，他和一批同学发起成立社会主义俱乐部，接着又被同学选出担任学生会的会长，同时积极参加与泛马学生联合会的活动。这个时候，包括新加坡在内的马来西亚社会。 经过二战的震荡和洗礼，人民要求自尊、当家做主的情绪与呼声已经酝酿多时，正步入沸腾之际。这一批血气方刚、目光敏锐的学生， 是实现社会改革为己任、义不容辞地走到时代潮流的最前列，投入揭露殖民主义者的丑恶嘴脸，唤醒人民自主自助意识的运动之中。他们创办了《黎明报刊》，也就是《Fajar》。那么该报刊 于1954年被殖民地政府以煽动罪名起诉时， Dr. Lim 当时是担任这个保卫华惹，也就是保卫这个报刊的基金的主席。就在捍卫华惹报的过程中，他揭示了初出茅庐的年轻律师李光耀。 华惹捍卫战胜利之后，他积极参与成立人民行动党，并成为该党的重要成员。可是他却在1958年该党的一次重新登记过程中，因为意见不合，不受当时党领导层的欢迎，而被终止了党籍。1957年 ，Dr. Lim 大学毕业， 正式成为一名医生，被派到中央医院和陈独生医院去服务。1961年，曾为了成立社会主义阵线政党，他辞了该项职务，与傅树凯医生共建人民医务所，一边行医，扶死旧伤，一边从政， 力求从宏观的层面改善广大人民的生活与社会面貌，以实现他心中为建立一个公平、民主、优雅的社会的崇高理想而奔波。1963年2月2日，他和百多名左翼人士，包括工运、农运与学运的积极分子被捕入狱。 在没有经过公开法庭审讯的情况下，被关了将近20年的漫长时光。这里让我读出已不成人贵的一首诗当中的一个小段：我怎能把那些粗暴的恶人忘却？在黑暗的掩护下， 他们在为这里的拘留所横行霸道，在我发抖裸露的躯体上倾倒一桶又一桶的冰凉的水，向我痛苦交加百般挣扎的身上袭击，还对着我冻僵的躯体嘲笑和戏弄。是什么诱使这些非人的禽兽 使诸如此像复仇一样的恶毒与暴虐，不是因为私人恩怨吧，也并非要结算私人的旧账，而是为了百姓民主诉求理念的分歧。到底这凶残暴虐从何来？是什么使人变成了禽兽？是黑暗，是欠缺严厉的监视， 让他们仅仅凭着一套耻辱不堪的法典和谎言，便在那里肆无忌惮的叫嚣造作。这个是陈仁贵的一首诗。Dr. Lim 常年的默默坚持，是人类品德的最高体现，是向恶势力发出最强有力的反击。他常常说，对方 可以关注我的躯体，但却关不住我的精神。Dr. Lim 酷爱旅行，有一次他对我这么说：“这么多年来，我虽然身在牢里，可是我却常常环游世界。” 因为我会神游，这是好一个乐观而又幽默的奇人所讲的话。在张仪以后， 正是 Dr. Lim 这种不屈不挠、永不言弃的无限的能量支持着他，同时也鼓舞着我们。他是我们困难中的益友，是启蒙的导师，也是黑暗中让我们看到光明的引路人。对他的恩典，我们永远感激不尽。 Dr. Lim 即将离开我们去见林青祥 James Puducherry Woodhull 李少主陈仁贵等许多英明勇敢的先烈，他的心情应该是欣慰的，因为在这个小岛上，人民对长期的欺压已经忍无可忍而积极求变。 去年的大选和最近的补选的结果，都可以看到端倪。年轻的一代对于人权、社会公平、民主与真理的诉求越来越强烈，他们的队伍也越来越壮大。就在上个星期六，一大群公民运动成员在芳林公园就发出了 要求废除恶名昭彰的内部安全法的呼声，而且要推动一场声势浩大的全民签名运动。另一方面，西方资本主义的危机还在苟延残喘当中，完全看不到一丝的解决的曙光，看来还可能拉倒世界经济秩序与架构， 使全世界陷入空前的大萧条当中。从大学生涯开始便崇奉社会主义的 Dr. Lim， 从近年来的世界局势的发展当中，必然会找到许多与他大学的读物所阐述的资本主义的这个悲惨的结局似曾相似的许多地方。 Dr. Lim 光辉的一生是结束了，他永远不言弃，坚守岗位，坚守信念，光明磊落，坚贞不渝的伟大精神，他的崇高的人格素养，应是后来者学习的榜样，应鼓舞我们大家去做个更好的人。中华文化里面有一句古语说：“人 故有一死，或重如泰山，或轻如鸿毛。”我们敬仰的 Dr. Lim 在我们的心中永远是一座巍峨壮观的泰山，他的英名应与朝阳同辉，与英雄同列。他劳劳碌碌的一生是结束了，安息吧，
我们伟大的英雄。 Hello. I believe Mr. Tan CJ would like to say a few words as well.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Lim and Dr. Lim. I'm very happy to be given this opportunity to speak, and I think the younger people, I mean younger, that means later, those who come after Dr. Lim Hock Siew should also speak, so that Dr. Lim Hock Siew is not just a man of the past, generation, but he lives on in us, the younger generation. Friends and fellow Singaporeans, Dr. Lim Hock Siew was my hero since I was a child. His name and the names of his comrades always got mentioned whenever my sisters and brothers discussed about the future of our country. It was the tumultuous days of the great anti-colonial era of the 1950s and the 1960s. We followed the speeches and movements of our heroes closely, looking for directions of what to do and how we could play a part. Our family lived in Queen Street, opposite the St. Anthony's Boys' Schools where I studied, and close to Catholic High School. At the other end of Queen Street was the Green Bus Depot, where there was a little newsstand. Every Saturday evening, my brothers and I would pick up a fresh copy of Zheng Xian Bao, hot from the press. It was also from there that I would get my copy of the Plebeian, the English newsletter of the Barisan Sosialis. Whenever I read the Plebeian, I felt as though Dr. Lim Hock Siew and his English educated comrades, such as Dr. Poh Soo Kai, Sai Zahari Woodhull, and others, were talking to me from their prison cells. They kept my interest in politics alive, even though they were locked away. So it was quite natural for me to choose to study philosophy, politics, and economics when I was offered a scholarship to study at Oxford University. It was a choice that did not go down well with the Public Service Commission at that time. I remember being told to choose to study economics with engineering science or not given a scholarship at all by the PSC. But I persisted and succeeded in persuading the PSC to let me study PPE. And I thank Dr. Lim Hock Siew and his comrades for inspiring me and cultivating in me from a very young age a lifelong interest in politics and the affairs of the country. His influence and the influence of his comrades did not stop with me. After I graduated and returned home for my interview with the PSC, the late chairman, Mr. Tan Teck Chui, asked me if I would recommend PPE for future scholars and how schools should prepare them for the course, since the emphasis had always been on science and engineering subjects for PSC scholars. I said yes without hesitation, and that schools should start special classes to prepare our students for the unfamiliar subject of PPE. I was glad to know that a few years later, the Promshow program was born at Hua Chong Junior College. As you know, Promshow, for those who are not familiar, Promshow stands for Pre-University Overseas Merit Scholarships for Humanities at Oxbridge. In the past, the study of politics was to be avoided like the plague. But today, PPE is the subject of choice of many Singaporeans, including PSC scholars. Many PPE graduates are now occupying key leadership positions in the Singapore government, banks, industry, and the professions. They are making important contributions to the country. And Dr. Lim Hock Siew and his comrades can feel proud of their indirect influence in inspiring and nurturing this pool of future leaders. The influence ideas of Dr. Lim Hock Siew followed me to the UK. I participated actively in student politics. I attended the meetings of FEMSO, the Federation of UK and all Malaysian and Singapore students' organizations. I remember distinctly in 1975, the annual conference of FEMSO at Sheffield University, where tape recordings of the speeches of Drs. Lim Hock Siew and Dr. Poh Soo Kai were played out, and they captivated the audience. Many of us made speeches in support of them and their struggles for Singapore, including me. It spoke, I was on a government scholarship, but anyway, I couldn't be bothered, I spoke. It spoke volumes of their influence on us and the support they have amongst students. I did not get to meet Dr. Lim Hock Siew in person until much, much later in life. One day last year, I received a text message from Ms. Teo Solang, who said Dr. Lim would like to meet up with me. I had just declared my intention to contest the 2011 presidential election. I said yes without hesitation and was looking forward to meeting a great hero of my life. Unfortunately, he fell ill, and I did not get to meet him until the occasion of the SDP National Day dinner, where he was given an award for his lifelong contribution to the country. I was so glad to meet him, to see him and his wife there. and I walked up to introduce myself and shake their hands. We chatted and I told him how much I admired him since my childhood days. I was also impressed by the absolute lack of bitterness against those who took away the best years of his life from him and his family. This made him truly great and undoubtedly places him in the class of world heroes like Nelson Mandela. Yes, I was delighted to have photographs taken together with him and his wife. They are now a treasure in my album collection. I subsequently met him again at the Dr. Ang Swee Chai lecture when I spotted him and I sat down next to him throughout the lecture. It was always a pleasure and delight to have a conversation with Dr. Lim, but unfortunately, there were not many opportunities to do so. But his ideas and influences live on in the many friends that I met with him and through him. In the last few days of his wake, I got to meet his family and his brothers and sisters who told me they were classmates of my two sisters, Ling Qiu and Ling Jing, at Chongqing High School and were active in student politics together. They also told me that Dr. Lim Hock Siew was my great supporter for the presidential election and was active in sending out text messages to his friends urging them to vote for me. I am greatly encouraged and heartened by this tribute from my hero, for which I am eternally grateful and will forever remember it in my heart. Dr. Lim Hock Siew is not a man of the past. His ideas of fairness and equality are as relevant today as they were more than 50 years ago when he started to espouse them. More and more Singaporeans, including many in the establishment, are now openly expressing ideas on doing something about income inequality. In this respect, Dr. Lim Hock Siew was ahead of his time with his ideas of socialism. He had the foresight to see far ahead of his political opponents. His untimely passing amidst the resurrection of the national debate on ideas of economic inequality that was so close to his heart is a great loss to us who treasure his thoughts and humility. But he can rest assured that his struggles would not be in vain, but would continue in the many young people that he had influenced and inspired, including myself. We will carry the torch and will surely succeed one day and make Dr. Lim Hock Siew very proud. May you finally rest in peace, Dr. Lim Hock Siew.
Thank you to all the speakers. Thank you everyone for braving the rain. I think it's coming down a bit heavier now. For those of you who wish to join us at the crematorium, it's at Bright Hill, Qing Guang Ming San. We have arranged for two buses to take everyone there. The buses just passed. They will be at the main road. As you come out, you turn left, it's at the main road, okay? So at this point, no more speakers. Can I perhaps invite those of you who wish to have a last visit to my father before his casket is brought out, and then I wish everyone well and I hope to see you again soon. Thank you.